I've been using DaVinci Resolve for at least 6 years now. The feature set it offers is still unmatched, but day after day I've shaped a workflow that lets me cut faster, grade cleaner, and deliver the best results for my clients and myself. These 5 plugins power that routine, and today I want to share them with you so you can improve your own system. Let's take a look. For those new to this channel, my name is Vitas, and it took me 5 years to go from beginner to paid video creator and colorist, and I'm here to share the shortcuts that saved me years of struggle. In this video, I'm covering my top 5 plugins outside of DaVinci Resolve that have helped me improve my editing and color grading workflows. I've kept my favorite for last, so stay tuned until the end. I'll start with the first one, which I crafted myself. It's called Asset Blaster, and it's built to save time animating assets and titles. Basically, it's very simple, nothing you can't already do in Resolve, but I gathered my most used animations and effects into one place and tweaked them to my liking. I've split the plugin into 3 parts. The top section is for transforming your asset, the middle is for animations, and the last is for effects. Let's drop a simple logo and test this thing. As I said before, the top section is pretty simple. You've got all your basic transform tools, resizing, positioning, and rotation. The middle part is for animations. I've made them a bit smoother than the stock ones, and they are set up so that if I shorten or cut a clip, the animation starts exactly at the beginning of a cut. We've got simple swipes from all 4 directions, a zoom in, a spin, and a few creative options. You can also combine them to build even more interesting moves. All of these animations are mirrored, which means the effect plays in and then reverses back out at the end. Lastly, at the bottom, we have effects panel to spice up your assets. Things like shake, outline, VHS, shadow, or black and white conversion. I've made 2 versions of the plugin. One for studio version of Resolve, and the one more simpler with less effects for a free version. By the way, you'll find step-by-step install and usage instructions inside the package. Oh, and I almost forgot, it's totally free. Alright, in 4th place I have a plugin from fellow creator Mr. Alex Tech. I strongly recommend his channel if you focus on editing in Resolve. He's got really great stuff. His plugin is called Magic Zoom, and it does exactly what it says, smooth zoom animations. The Pro version comes with a stack of presets, and you can even build your own. There's also a free version that works well, but if you want all the bells and whistles, grab the Pro. It costs only 30 bucks, and that's a great investment for editors in my opinion. I've purchased the Pro version right away after trying the free one, and I've used Magic Zoom since the start of my channel. You can easily spot those fancy pushes in my videos all the time. Great plugin, and a big shout out to Mr. Alex. Great job.
I think he's doing a great job. He's a smart guy, very smart.
At the 3rd spot, I put a tool that helps me balance the image, which for someone who loves color grading is a must have. This one's from a company called Mono Nodes, and the plugin itself is called Mono Balance. It's a DCTL plugin that helps nail white balance and skin tones. If you are new to DCTL, it stands for DaVinci Color Transform Language, the scripting system for custom color transform plugins inside Resolve. There are plenty of great DCTLs out there, but that's a topic for another video. So, here's how I used the plugin. I drop Mono Balance at the end of my node tree, but placing it next to my Balance node. By default, it's disabled, and when I start balancing, I switch it on. I tick neutrals to green, which overlays green dots wherever true neutral colors should sit. Then I tweak white balance until those green patches match the spots that should be white, black, or gray. Next, I check skin tones. They should sit in the yellow zone. If they flash green, the skin tones are too green, and if they flash magenta, it's too magenta. Additionally, there's a monochrome checkbox for checking contrast and an exposure map for fine-tuning exposure. I think it's a great utility tool for colorists. The whole utility pack costs around 90 euros, but there's a similar free tool from Pixel Tools worth a look. I'll drop both links in the description. Second spot goes to film emulation plugin Dehancer. I love the film look, and this tool delivers it. I use it on music videos, travel content, and even some client projects. It's not perfect, but once you learn its quirks, it really shines. I've already made a separate video on how I use it, so check that out if you haven't seen it. In simple words, Dehancer lets you build a custom film look with print stock emulations, and there are plenty to choose from classic motion stocks like Kodak Vision to photo favorites from Fuji or Agfa. It also packs extras like bloom, halation, color head, overscan, everything you need to dial in that vintage vibe. Best of all, it drops straight into my DaVinci wide gamut workflow, which is flexible and convenient for me. Or you can grade using only Dehancer if you prefer. I usually place it at the end of my node tree, right before the Rec 709 conversion node. Most times I start by applying the film emulation first and then grade from there. It's not the cheapest plugin out there, but for film color lovers, it's a great tool to have around. If you decide to try it out, use my 10% discount code. I'll earn a small commission and you'll get a better deal. Simple. And finally, my favorite. Technically, it's not just a plugin, it's a whole platform of plugins and templates called Motion VFX. You've probably already heard of it somewhere on the lands of the internet. And these packs are a golden treasure box for editors. The first pack I bought was called Journey for my travel videos, and I don't regret the purchase to this day. Basically, every pack comes with a bunch of typography, effects, overlays, transitions, and other great stuff that just lands in your effects panel in the edit page. All this stuff is very flexible, which means you can modify all the effects and make it your own style. Let's take a look at what's inside these packs, as I have a few of them now. Another great thing I like about Motion VFX is that a lot of these packs come from fellow creators I watch on YouTube myself. For example, there's a nice package from tech giant star MKBHD or filmmaker Christopher Rhodes. I like to craft my own titles, effects, and animations, so who knows? Maybe one day Motion VFX will offer me a collaboration on a new pack. Wish me good luck on that one. But for now, I can strongly recommend checking already great templates they offer. So there you have it, my 5 go-to plugins. They boost my speed, accuracy, and overall polish, so they are well worth checking out. And if you are just starting out in the Resolve, watch my hour-long color grading tutorial next. See you in the next one.